Dear students, we are going to start exercise 9.4. First question: Can these sets of number be the possible length of the sides of a right angle triangle? In previous exercise, we have done: Can these sides be the sides of a triangle, on simple triangle? If we want to show the given sides are the sides of a triangle, we apply triangle inequality property. But to show the given sides are the sides of a right angle triangle, we need to apply Pythagoras theorem. And according to that theorem, you know very well, the square of hypotenuse is equal to sum of square of other two sides, means perpendicular square plus base square. Now you must be thinking, which is hypotenuse, which is base? We don't know. But in previous module I have told you, the greatest side is always hypotenuse. So we will consider the greatest side as hypotenuse. We are going to check. We are not sure if these are the sides of triangle or not. But we know the hypotenuse is the greatest side. So we will take the greatest side as hypotenuse. So we will prove, if the left hand side and right hand sides are equal, by putting these values in left hand side and right hand side, then you can say these are the possible lengths of a right angle triangle. So first, left hand side, that is x square. X square means h into h. H means hypotenuse, and we are taking the greatest side is 5. 5 as hypotenuse. 5 into 5, you will get 25. And now you can take P as 3 or B as 3, that is your wish. Okay, so P square plus B square. P means, P square means P into P. B square means B into P. P is 3 into 3 plus 4 into 4. 3 into 3, 9. 4 into 4, 16. 16 plus 9, 25. Now you can see x square is equal to P square plus B square. Means left hand side is equal to right hand side. It means the given sides are the sides of a right angle triangle. There, so you will write, yes, 3 cm, 4 cm and 5 cm are the possible lengths of a sides of right angled triangle. Clear? So first you take, you will consider the greater side as hypotenuse. Take its square, 5 multiplied by 5, 25. Now we will take right hand side. P square means P into P plus B square means B into P. So you can take any side, other two side. One is base and one is perpendicular. So 3 into 3 plus 4 into 4. 9 plus 16, you will get 25. It means the left hand side is equal to right hand side. Means it satisfies the Pythagoras theorem. So that's why these are the possible sides of a right angle triangle. Clear? So let's check with another sides, 1.5, 3.6 and 3.9. 1.5, 3.6 and 3.9 cm. Now, which is the greatest side? Yes, 3.9. So we will take 3.9 as hypotenuse. So h is 3.9. You can take base either 1.5 or 3.6. And never forget to write the unit. And perpendicular is 3.6 cm. So first, according to Pythagoras theorem, we will take the square of hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is 3.9 into 3.9. Multiply 39 by 39. The 27 and 30, 35. Now 3, 9, 27, 3, 3, 9 and 2, 11. So you will get, and the decimal will come after 2 digits. Clear? Now I am taking b square plus p square. B means 1.5 into 1.5. P means 3.6 into 3.6. Multiply by 15 by 15. You will get 225. Means 2.25. Multiply 36 by 36. Will get 12.96. Now add these two numbers, 12.96, 2.25, 6 and 5, 11. You will get 15.21. Both are same. It means these are also the possible sides of a right angle triangle. You will write yes. Okay, clear? If it is asked whether the given sets of number are the sides of a triangle only, in that case you need to apply triangle inequality property. But if it is asked the given sets of numbers are the sides of a right angle triangle, in that case you need to apply this Pythagoras theorem. X square is equal to P square plus P square. Is that clear?